Now to the wonderful man who got the whole world in the mood for dancing and maybe a cocktail or two or three. For six decades, Sergio Mendes has won millions of fans with his Brazilian influence on contemporary music. Let's hear a few reminders of his beautiful arrangements for his band, Brazil 66. Grammy winner, composer, arranger, band leader, and so much more. We are absolutely thrilled. Sergio Mendes in Australia for his latest tour, and he joins us this morning on Studio 10.
Wow.
Sergio, welcome to Studio 10. Thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
Now, I understand your love of music. Your mum encouraged you to play the piano when you were super young, and then someone gave you a jazz album at about 11 or 2, and that's where you found your love of jazz.
That's
right. Is that right?
Yeah, that was a Dave Brubeck record.
Oh.
Yes, Take 5.
Take 5.
I heard that. I said, wow, what a beautiful sound. And the first time I heard jazz, and this was at the same time that Bossa Nova was starting in Brazil, which this year, 60 years of Bossa Nova, 1958. And the great songs, you know, The Girl from Ipanema, Desafinado. Yes. And
Brazilian and music is really joyous, isn't it?
It is, absolutely.
You know, you have to start moving and dancing. And
that's correct, yes. Yeah. But also very romantic and very sensual.
Mm. Yes.
So if you put those things together, I think it's a good combination.
And of course, you played a huge role in bringing Bossa Nova to the US, to the world, to the world stage. What was it like back then, in the swinging 60s, being at the forefront of a kind of musical revolution?
Well, you know, coming from Brazil, I came in to America in 64, so I was a young kid, and I had a great time. It was like, for me, it was like discovering things.
It must have just been electric.
It was wonderful, the 60s, absolutely.
Oh. Yeah. But your music is still popular. How do you explain its longevity?
I think the melodies, the songs. The songs are so important to me. So when you hear a song like Mashkinada that I recorded twice, I recorded in 66 and then with the Black Eyed Peas again in 2006, so 40 years later, it was so it's a little, you know, I like the word serendipity.
What was it like working with the Black Eyed Peas?
It was wonderful.
Oh,
it's great.
Will I Am
is a dear friend, and there he is.
Yeah.
And
so cool.
And that's so great to play that song again and bring it to a whole new audience, you know, which we did.
Speaking of bringing songs back to life, breathing new life into them, Paul McCartney actually wrote you to thank you for your arrangement of Fool on the Hill, which
that's
we heard
right.
a little bit of
that's right.
in the intro.
What
must that have been like?
Again, when I heard the song, it was the album Magical Mystery Tour, and I heard that melody, and I said, wow, I love that song, you know, so we did that. I did an arrangement and became a big hit. And he liked it.
And what did he say in the letter? What did he say?
He said, thank you, this is my favorite version of my song. Thank you for recording. Yeah, I was very touched.
That is
I have the letter.
And Sergio, you met Harrison Ford before he was Harrison Ford, didn't you?
Absolutely.
What was he doing?
You know, I decided to build a studio in my house and I was looking for a carpenter.
He was
my carpenter.
There he is.
Are you serious?
There he is. It was a 2x4.
Oh, no.
Very good. Good-looking carpenter there.
Yeah.
Was he a good carpenter?
Fantastic.
Was he?
Fantastic. Yeah, amazing. Everything beautiful. And this is before he did his first movie. And it was great.
Did you ever see him afterwards? Did you ever say to him, I recognize you, you're a great
carpenter? You know, we're just they're doing a documentary about my life, and they interview Harrison, and I went to say hello to him just a few months ago in Los Angeles. It was so good to see him. And he was very charming and very nice.
He said, can you come back and fix my floorboards?
You, of course, have a great band and you've worked with so many incredible stars. I want to take you to have a bit of an opportunity to listen to Tom Jones singing with your group. Let's take a listen at that.
They took a samba and mixed it with maraca too. And the magic way it gets me, it's got to get to you. For more than anything, I love the samba. The beat I can't ignore.
What's that like? I mean, you've had such an incredible influence on so many people right around the world.
Again, it's the song. There is the song, you know?
Yeah.
And the song, the nice thing about some of those songs, that when we play them now live, which we're going to do here in Australia, they feel fresh. They feel like... they feel new, you know?
Yes.
I mean, it's a strange feeling.
They're timeless, really.
I'm sorry?
They're timeless.
Yeah, timeless.
You know, they just keep going on.
Yeah.
Now, you've sung with your wife, or your wife has sung with you on stage.
Yeah,
she
will.
You got married 70 years ago.
We got married about 46 years ago.
In the 70s?
Yeah, and she's in the band. There she is.
Wow. How have you adapted to all the changes?
Right?
How have you adapted to all the changes in the music industry over that time?
That's a show we did in France.
Oh, beautiful.
And did Paul McCartney send you a letter about that as well? Because he worked with his wife on stage. Does that create any, you know, musical...
No.
We hear about bands splitting up because of musical differences all the time.
No.
You and your wife ever have musical differences?
No, no.
She touring with you this time?
Yeah, she's here. She's on the way to Canberra as we speak.
Right. What I loved is when we mentioned your wife, you were still staring at her so lovingly on screen with the look of love.
Oh, I love that. I know. What a song.
Is that where all the inspiration comes from? Because, you know, as you mentioned before, it is beautiful music. It's all about love and sensuality,
yes.
And it brings joy to so many people's lives.
Absolutely. You're right. It's about joy.
Yeah, it is.
Do you have other couples coming to you and saying, oh, this was our wedding song, or this was the song we first, you know?
You know, actually, the wedding song, a song that I recorded, I don't know if you have a video, it's called Never Gonna Let You Go.
Yes.
Remember that?
Yes. Yes.
So that became the wedding song. So my son is getting married in June. So I'm gonna play the song and she's gonna sing.
Oh, that's
Yeah.
Because it's interesting, you use a lot of female voices with your work.
Yes, I love
that. You can, it matches.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm just a piano player. There.
And thank you for bringing so much joy to so many people's lives.
Yes.
Beautiful
pleasure.
Music.
Great to be back in Australia, by the way.
Oh, it's great to have you.
Country, isn't it? And the concert tour for Sergio Mendes kicks off tomorrow night in Canberra. There are all the dates on your screen. Of course, going to Melbourne, the Sydney Opera House. What a great place to play.
Some of the huge houses
Brown
too.
Theatre in Perth. Also, all the ticketing details and information, there they are on your screen, ticketmaster.com.au. A big round of applause for the wonderful Sergio Mendes.